So today we will discuss about the process, non-flow process, that is your polytropic process. Okay. So polytropic process follow which law? That is Vb to the power n is equal to constant. Before we read that isentropic process, that is adiabatic process, that is Pb to the power gamma equal to constant, that same the derivation, all the working derivation, work done derivation is same as the reversible adiabatic process. In place of gamma here n is there. So Pb to the power n equal to constant. So, for a process 1 to 2, what we can write? P1 V1 to the power n is equal to P2 V to the power n. So, suppose we have to find out n, that polytropic index. What is n? N is your polytropic index. That how you find out? The formula is ln P2 by P1 is equal to ln V1 by V2. And the relationship are same as the adiabatic process. Only the difference is in place of gamma, here n is there. So, P2 by P1 is equal to V1 by V2 to the power n is equal to V2 2 by V1 to the power minus n. That you can, if you want, see, then you can see the adiabatic process, how it was derived. Next, T2 by T1 is equal to V2 by V1 to the power 1 minus n. V2 by V1 is equal to P2 by P1 minus 1 by n. Temperature pressure relation, that is T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 n minus 1 by n. And what is the work done? Work done is equal to P2 V2 minus P1 V1 divided by 1 minus n, or you can say MR T2 minus T1 divided by 1 minus n. So, in plus upper P1 V1. So, P1 V1 minus P2 V2 by n minus 1, or MR T1 minus T2 by n minus 1. And the work done is similar to your adiabatic process, and before also we derived that work done. Only I have write this formula here. The change in internal energy du, that is same for all the gases, mcv t2 minus t1. What is change in enthalpy? Change in enthalpy dh is equal to mcp t2 minus t1. That is also same for all the gases. Next we will discuss is your heat transfer. Okay. Then what is heat transfer? According to first law of thermodynamics for non-flow process, what is the first law of thermodynamics for non-flow process? Q is equal to du plus w. Heat transfer is equal to change in internal energy plus work done. So what is your change in internal energy? That is mcv t2 minus t1. And what is work done? Mr t1 minus t2 by 1 minus n. Okay. So, here if I taking the common of m t2 minus t1. Here it is your m t2 minus t1 divided by 1 minus n. Not t1 by t2. It is your t2 minus t1. Okay. That is your m cv t2 minus t1 plus mr t2 minus t1 divided by 1 minus n. So, here also m t2 minus t1, here also m t2 minus t1. So, I am taking common. So, what is left? Cv plus r by 1 minus n. So, what is r? R is the difference between cp minus cv, specific heat at constant pressure minus specific heat at constant volume. So, that is the relation cp minus cv is equal to r. So, in plus of r I put cp minus cv. Then I am taking the LCM 1 by n. Here it is the same. So, that is Cb 1 minus n plus Cp minus Cb. So, Cb, if we multiply Cb into 1 minus n, Cb minus n into Cb plus Cp minus Cb. The Cb, Cb will be cancelled out. What is left? M T2 minus T1 minus Cb n in plus Cp divided by 1 minus n. So, what is left? M T2 minus T1 Cp minus n Cb divided by 1 minus n. So, Q is equal to M. That Cp minus n Cb divided by 1 minus n, I am taking as a constant, that is Cn. So, Q is equal to mCn T2 minus T1. What is Cn? Cn is equal to Cp minus n Cb divided by 1 minus n. So, what is the heat transfer for polytropic process? Q is equal to mCn dt. So, mCn dt, what is Cn? Cn is the this value. Clear? So, if you know that Q is equal to m Cp minus Cn Cb divided by 1 minus n into T2 minus T1. So, suppose I am taking common of Cb. What is left? Cp minus Cp by Cb minus n into T2 1. T1, what is Cp by Cb? Is equal to gamma. So, Cb into gamma minus n divided by 1 minus n. So that is gamma minus n, 1 minus n, it will be taking one side, then mCb T2 minus T1. So what is mCb? Cb value we derived before also, that is R by 1 minus gamma minus 1. Cb will be, the value of Cb is equal to R by gamma minus 1. Then what is left? MR T2 by T1 divided by 1 minus n. Then what is left? Gamma minus n divided by gamma minus 1. So gamma minus n divided by gamma minus 1. So MR T2 minus T1 divided by 1 minus n. Then what is your MR T2 minus T1 divided by 1 minus n? That is the polytropic work transfer. So gamma minus n divided by gamma minus 1 into polytropic work transfer, that is also give you what? Heat transfer. Okay. Q is equal to mcn dt and Q is equal to gamma minus n by gamma minus 1 into polytropic work transfer, that will also give you the heat transfer. Okay. Then we go for change in internal energy, change in entropy. What is change in entropy? Ds is equal to del Q by T. Ds integration, that is S. Limit from 1 to 2, that is S2 minus S1, and that is integration of 1 to 2 del Q by T. What is the del Q? Change heat transfer for your polytropic process, that is MCN dt. So MCN, that is constant, that will become outside. What is left? Integration of dt by T from 1 to 2. Then what is the 1 by T dt integration? That is ln T, limit 1 to 2. So we can put MCN, upper limit, ln T2 minus ln T1. That is ln T2 minus T1, you can write ln T2 by T1. So what is your S2 minus S1? Or for the process, that is S1 to entropy for process 1 to, that is MCN ln T2 by T1. That is for entropy for polytropic process. Okay. For what is the change in entropy for constant pressure process or isobaric process? MCP, constant volume, MCB. For isothermal, Q heat transfer is equal to work transfer. Okay. MR ln T2 by T1. So, this is the heat change in entropy for your polytropy process. Next, we will discuss your last article, that is free expansion process. Okay. So, what do you mean by free expansion? The name says that the expansion will not undergone by any force or any kind of external work. It will be freely expand. Okay. Suppose we consider there are two chamber A and B. We consider two chamber here A and B, which is perfectly insulated. And B chamber is your vacuum. A chamber having some gas having pressure P1, volume V1 and temperature T1. And the boundary is insulated. Insulated means here there will be no heat transfer across the system and surrounding. Between AB system and the surrounding, there will be no heat transfer. Okay. Suppose here I am making an hole, or you can make a orifice here or make you an hole. So what will happen between A and B chamber if you make an hole here or any if I make any hole, then what will happen? Here it is the vacuum. Vacuum means negative pressure. Here having pressure is P1. Then what will happen? From the A chamber, all the gas will be go to the chamber B. How or why? Because of pressure difference. Here there is negative pressure. Here having some pressure P1. So due to pressure difference, if you make a hole here, small hole, then what will happen? Gases from the section A or chamber A will be go to the chamber B. Then what is the condition? After that you can see that this chamber having, there is no separate chamber. One chamber having pressure P2, volume V2 and temperature T2. This is the before expansion and this is after. So if you make an hole and gas will be pass through the orifice or surface and go to the vacuum, then that is known as your what? That is known as your expansion. Okay. So, what is free expansion? So, when the gases are passes over this small hole, then what will happen? So, between them, there will be random molecular motion between them. They are, here it is having some pressure. The gases are under pressure. If you make a hole, all the gases will be try to expand. All the gases will be try to go to the chamber B. So, that process is known as your what? It is expansion. So, we are not applying any external force to move the gas from A chamber to B chamber. So, automatically due to pressure difference, it will be From the A chamber, all the gases will be sent to the B chamber. So, that process is known as your free expansion process. Though there are the molecular, Rosses. So, this process is known as your what? Irreversible process. The free expansion process is an irreversible process or irreversible non-flow process. A free expansion occurs when a fluid is allowed to expand suddenly into the vacuum chamber through an orifice of large dimension. Orifice means if you make a hole between A and B chamber, there is a wall. Between the wall, if you make a hole, that hole is known as small hole is known as your what? Orifice. Okay. Since there is no expansion of the boundary of the system because it is rigid, there is no work done. So, here the boundary is not enlarged. What will do? The gas will be from the A chamber, it will be go to the B chamber. But here, there will be no work done. This boundary does not expand. So, if the boundary does not expand, so that means there is no work is done on the boundary. So, in the free expansion process, there is no work done. Because only gases are moved from A chamber to B chamber. But there will be no boundary movement of the because of gas. So, that is no work transfer. So, thus, for a free expansion process, heat transfer is equal to 0 because it is insulated. Work done is equal to 0. Okay. Then, change in internal energy is also 0. The following point may be noted that since the system is perfectly insulated, so that no heat transfer takes place. So, Q12 is equal to 0. Therefore, the expansion of gas may be called adiabatic expansion. Clear? Next point, since pre-expansion of the gases takes place suddenly, therefore intermediate state will not be in equilibrium state. The process is irreversible and the expansion is therefore known as irreversible expansion. According to the first law of thermodynamics, Q12 is equal to W12 plus change in internal energy. So, if Q is equal to heat transfer is equal to 0, work transfer is equal to 0, then change in internal energy is equal to 0. So, what is change in internal energy? U2 minus U1 is equal to 0. So, that is U2 is equal to U1. Okay. So, free expansion process is also known as your constant internal energy process. U2 is equal to U1. We know that change in internal energy du is equal to mcv dt. If du is equal to 0, then dt is equal to 0. If dt is equal to 0, then t2 minus t1 is equal to 0 or t2 is equal to t1. So, that is temperature of the system also remain constant. So, free expansion process, what you get? Work done is equal to 0, heat transfer is equal to 0, it is irreversible expansion or adiabatic expansion. Here, this process is your constant internal energy process and this is your temperature of the system remain constant. So, that we got from the free expansion process. This is most important when you go for attending exam. So, what is change in enthalpy? We know that dh is equal to mcp dt. So, if dt is equal to 0, then dh is equal to 0. So, what is dh? Dh is equal to h2 minus h1. So, that is equal to h2 is equal to h2. The free expansion process also be called as constant enthalpy process. Clear? Then we will discuss is your throttling process. These two processes are most important. The throttling process is an irreversible steady flow expansion process in which perfect gases expand through a restricted passage or a slightly open valve as shown in figure. Here, the pressure is dropped and the gas should come out with large velocity. Since no heat is supplied or rejected during the throttling process, also no work is done, therefore heat transfer is equal to 0 and work transfer is equal to 0. So, see, restricted passage or you can say that it is a slightly open valve. So, this is a slightly open valve. So, water will be come from here and it will be passes through this area and it will be come out, go outside. So, this is your what? Porous plug. This is also a throttling process. Porous plug is your, you know that in your filter, candles are used. So, you can consider this is also a porous plug. Okay. So, here if the water will be flow inside the porous plug, then that is known as your which process? Throttling process. If any liquid will be passed through a narrow or restricted passage, so what will happen? The pressure will be dropped. That process is known as the throttling process. So, suppose you are taking section 1 inlet and section 2 your outlet, what will happen? GZ1. So, if there is a flow process, so we can apply the steady flow energy equation. So, what is the steady flow energy equation? That is GZ1 plus V1 square by 2 H1 plus Q is equal to GZ2. So, here velocity is not that will considerable change. V1 is equal to V2, Z1 is equal to Z2. Okay. Now